Well, hello everyone, I'm Yanni from BFU Gaming, and today we're gonna take a look at Time Mysteries Inheritance, and this is the remastered version. A good friend of mine gifted me this game, so I thought I would give it a little look and see what it's all about. So thank you very much for giving me the opportunity to do that, Lope. This is going to be interesting because this is a 2D adventure mystery hidden object game. I haven't played a lot of hidden object games, if any at all. I can't even remember. I don't think I have any on my channel, do I? Well, then I'm going to have one now, so you guys can also get a chance to see what this is about. But this is developed by Artifex Mundi, and it is the first chapter out of three, so there are two other games that are the other chapters. It was released back in 2010, but this enhanced version is from 2014, and it is €7.99 on Steam. It consists of 27 varied mini-games as well as 31 hidden object scenes, and it has the enhanced version has a fully voiced dialogue for all the characters, and apparently there are 10 mysterious characters in this game. So let's just try and jump in and see what it's all about. So I am just gonna choose my name as usual. There we go. Welcome, Yanni. Nice. Save up to 50%. I guess it's somewhere you can get the game, and this is probably for the full collection of the games, I would suspect. Let's take a look at the options. We can rate and review. Well, I haven't tried playing yet, so let's just skip that one and go to the settings. Music volume, sound volume. Well, so far I think it is at a reasonable level, otherwise I'll have to adjust it in the edit afterwards. Custom cursor, full screen mode. Okay, that kind of changed things. Let's just go back to, so it was full screen. I was just wondering if it's windowed, even though it shouldn't be because I can't see the border, but sometimes it's borderless windowed and I don't find out about that unless I click on full screen mode. Voiceovers. Okay, well, I think we're just gonna leave all of this on default. I don't know what regular mode is, but okay. And let's just say play. Oh, there we go. Regular mode. The hints as well as the skip button take little time to recharge. Active zones glimmer from time to time. There is no penalty for clicking too much in hidden object scenes. Okay, then there's the expert mode. The hints and the skip button take longer to recharge. Active zones are not indicated, and clicking too much in hidden object zones is or scenes is penalized. Well, I think we're gonna go with regular mode because I'm definitely not an expert in these types of games, so this is fine.
Years ago, my father sparked my interest in the sciences. My studies only fanned the flames. Before long, I was working abroad as a physicist. All that hard work has finally paid off, and I can't wait to surprise Father with the results. Looks like home sweet home hasn't changed much. Wait, that light in the attic. Father sealed the attic decades ago, so who is in that window?
Ooh. That was mysterious. Would you like to use some interactive help? Well, let's just say yes to find out what it is. I guess it's just a tutorial. Notice that the cursor will change into a hand if there is an object to pick up. Click on the diary to pick it up. Yeah, so it turns into a hand, as you can see. Let's just do that. Happy birthday, Vivian. It is with great honor and affection that I pass down your inheritance. Hidden in the family chest is a crystal ball and 7 magic rings. May they bring you joy and good fortune. Use them wisely and they will manifest your dreams. Love, Dad. Aww. So where is Dad? Is he dead? Or... Okay. You may go to the diary at any time to access information on your objectives and past adventures. So that is down here. Yep. Notes provide you with background connected to the plot. To see your tasks, check the objectives. Okay, so this was what we just read. Then we can go to objectives, explore the chest, and find the moon-shaped key. Here you can remind yourself of the task at hand. Completed tasks are grayed out and marked with a green tick. Okay, well, we have explored the chest right here. Oh, there's even information. I've come here straight from the award ceremony, but instead of my father, there was this strange man in the attic, and now no one's here. All I've found is this diary. What is the meaning of this? Yeah, I'm wondering the same thing. Okay, that was happy birthday, and then we have this one. So if I click on objectives again, can I... Oh, that's the same. Okay. No problem. Cool. If an object may be used or examined closely, the cursor will change into a magnifying glass. Uh-huh. Ew. Okay, so we have a picture here that might be of our mom and some kind of box. We have the London Gazette. So are we... Okay. We are in Britain somewhere, I would suspect. Maybe in outside London, maybe. And of course we have the keys right there. And as you can see, it was kind of glimmering a little bit there. Now we have a key. Awesome. Okay. Looks like it has told me everything it wants to tell me. So I guess this is the help section. Ah, okay, it tells me what I want to do. So it's not a help section, it just gives me a hint. And then we have the menu over here. Okay, continue. And diary and... Okay, my inventory. Okay, click on an inventory item to use it. Notice the cursor will morph into that item. Now click on the key. Okay. And click on this. Objective accomplished. Explore the chest. Okay, new objective. Something. I was a little slow to read that. I don't remember this green covering on the lid. Father must have added it. That's interesting. That's like a pentagram. I think I once saw a medallion shaped like that in this house. Okay, like the cover or like this? Probably like this. So we can open the bottom of the trunk, probably, or the chest. Okay, we've got some pictures. That looks like that, and then with some guy. Who is this man in the funny garb next to father? He is definitely dressed interestingly. Okay. Can I click escape? No, then I go out here. I just wanted to see if I could close it down without waiting for the X. Okay, looks... I think it just registers this still. Yes, and then this. Okay. Cool. Well, actually I want to try without... let me see options. Go to expert mode. Hints on the skip button take longer to recharge. That's fine. Active zones are not indicated. I kind of want to try that. Okay, let's just try. So it doesn't like tell me if something is something we can do with, something with. We have the chest. Okay. Ooh, what are you? The safe is locked. I must create a path for the metal ball to unlock it. Oh, okay. Well, I need to do something so it can fall down, but... Yeah, if I do... what was that? Okay, then it will fall down there, and then if I do this... It can fall out to this, but then it goes out here. Might not be very handy. I do this instead. And this. Hey, achievement unlocked. Faster than light. I don't think that was very fast though. Oh, objective accomplished. Find the moon-shaped key. Okay, let's go back in here. and click the medallion. Click that here. Ooh, okay. What did I...
It's not like Father to lock up a hokey crystal ball.
Hey, who are you calling hokey? Magic is based in science, you know.
You can talk? Oh, please, pardon my manners. I can't find my father, and it's put me on edge.
As it should. Stare into me, and I will show you what happened here. A strange man appeared in this attic, demanding your father turn over a set of precious rings. Mm-hmm. When your father refused, the stranger became very agitated. What happened next is unclear. There was a popping noise, then they both disappeared in a flash of light.
Oh no! Father!
It may sound incredible, but he can be rescued. Only with your help. The rings are well hidden in the attic. Find them, and then maybe we can find your father.
Ooh, okay. So we have to go into the attic. Well, let's see if there's something else here that we can do anything with. Mr. Ambrose was my grandfather. He was a well-known magician and medium. Okay. That's just a chest. The hit boxes are a little outside, like... I actually wanted to check this out, but this is what we clicked on. Spiritist and medium. Okay. Anything else? Oh, wow. Oh, did I just end up in the attic? Sona. Okay, back. Maybe. Okay, well, let's see. Oh, we have an old phone here. That with a playing card. Oh, I have an old camera. Okay, we need to find... I guess if we're in the attic, we need to find the rings. Okay, we have a snail. That looks part of a... what is it called in English? A gramophone? Well, that's what we would call it in Danish. Got an old baseball. Hidden card right there. Butterfly. More hidden cards. Okay. What is this? Chuckle mini game. Okay, so maybe I don't need to find anything. Maybe I just have to pick that because it doesn't seem like there's anything that we can do anything with. Let's try. Ooh, okay. Boxing gloves, baseball bat, maple leaf, cricket bat. shuffle. Okay, do I have to find tree? Maybe. Okay. So it's like just finding as many as you can. Okay, let's take that. You. Okay, and it actually clears everything that is connected. That's pretty cool. Okay. Ooh. Okay. Interesting. Okay, we can't click on those, so I don't really know what they do. This seems like... Well, I don't know if we're supposed to fill this, but I guess we are. Just trying this out. And then go for you. Oh, now we have another one. But how do I... Can I do anything with it? No, doesn't seem like I can. I'm not quite sure what I'm supposed to do. Let's just see. Aha! Okay, it actually tells me something. I thought it would just give me a hint. Okay, find a group of three or more gems. Once you collect enough, a golden question mark will appear. Collect it to find one hidden object. But how do I collect it? To destroy this wall, you must collect the neighboring gems. Ah. Okay. Collect coils to charge a special power. Unleash it to destroy the whole row. Okay. When you can't find more matches, press shuffle button. This gem is trapped. You cannot collect it, but if you collect the whole group, you'll destroy its cage. Okay. Uh-huh. So if I want to destroy this wall, I have to collect some of these, but they are not three, so okay. 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 What if we take this one? And this. Then we can destroy part of it. Oh, so I got it now? Did I get it? Oh, what is this? Cricket, bat, and scissors. So I have to get all the words, maybe? Perhaps. Okay, I didn't collect this, so how do I collect it? I'm not sure how I actually collected the other one. Use this. Okay, now I got it. Nice. Okay, I can destroy this. Do that, and then maybe now. Oh, it has to be connected to the ones that you remove, I think. Yeah, now we got some more words. Interesting. Oh, boom. There we go, and then we can get the green one. Just try and fill this up again. And oh, maybe not you, maybe you. Nice. Okay, now we got another one. So now we can remove this one. And then take the blue one. So that gave me another word. Watch. Okay. Going and take the green ones. Bring in a nice. There we go, we're getting close. Ooh, boom. Okay, let's take this one. And this one, maybe. Then we can take the blue ones, of course. And the green ones. That gave me another word. Okay, we have 5 words left. Me another one. Awesome. And then we can take this one. Cool. Okay, so last word. I haven't really seen any of the other ones where something got stuck or something, but that might be something we'll see later on. Take this. And there we go. The ones where they were stuck in a cage or something. Well done, scissors. Okay. I got some scissors. Okay, maybe it was just a minigame, so it's not the actual attic. Why are you... That's kind of interesting. Okay, it was just kind of changing the light. Let's check out this. My father told me our family once owned such a manor generations ago. Okay. But how do I actually kind of go into the attic, for instance? Oh, the London Times. I thought it said the London Gazette in the previous one. 35 pence, new Stonehenge host to unique event. Archaeologists conclude excavation, party time, everyone is invited. The Stonehenge in Amesbury. Okay, unique in the 4,000 year history of Stonehenge, it is to be the setting of the biggest party ever recorded. Okay. Oh yeah, you can see Thursday, November 6th, 2010. It's that's where, back when the game was actually... released the first time, the older version of it. Okay, so how do I oh no, that's just this one. It doesn't really Okay, so I have scissors. Can I use the scissors on this? No? No. Is there anything I would want to use this on, I wonder. I have some papers here. Okay, let's check the diary. Objectives. Cut open the chest lid to learn what's inside. Yeah, okay, that makes sense. I kind of forgot about that because I was so focused on this. There we go. Okay. So we found all the rings. Nice. And this one. Awesome.
Now that we have the rings, let's travel and rescue your father.
Travel? But my passport... Hey, what's happening? Who just hit and run on the celestial road? Hey, Ball, where are we going?
Somewhere beyond time.
Oh, I guess we're not in England anymore, Ball. Oh, this place is amazing.
I'm cracking! Quickly, Vivian! Place me on the pedestal of the Nexus machine before I shatter!
Oh my goodness, how did this happen? Did the crash of that man in the vortex crack you?
Indeed! Now kindly get on with placing me in the Nexus machine. Phew! This should slow down the cracking process. Now, place the rings in the machine. Their magic is all that can heal me.
I don't know how to tell you this, but the rings are gone. I dropped them in the crash.
You must find them, and before the man who took your father and hit you in the vortex does. The vortex will have sent the rings to their former owners. Head to the Middle Ages and find Sir Bodwin of Phoenix. He will help you.
The Middle Ages? But how does one get there?
Go to the archive room and collect items from the Middle Ages to travel there.
Okay, that is interesting. Oh, so I can speak? Oh, what was this? Time machine. Okay, go to the archive room and find objects from the desired time. Okay, but how do I... time machine, museum of time. Ball. Okay, I had to go out one more. Time machine. Okay. I'm not going to open those doors at random. Wow, look at all those doors. Aha. Okay, Middle Ages. Interesting. Let's see. Middle Ages. Can I zoom in or something? No. Okay. What do I know about the Middle Ages? Wow. I keep thinking Robin Hood and stuff like that. Let's see. Middle Ages. No. Rolls. Doesn't that clothes look a little too old to be Middle Ages? Maybe it's just me. We have some gloves there. No, I'm not really. Not really light up or anything. Okay, maybe I need to hit that barrel. Oh, toggle minigame. Okay, maybe we should do that. Aha, so now we got a minigame with this stuff. Okay. Wasn't these the ones that were kind of trapped? Then I had to destroy the ones around them. Oh, okay, I can do it like this. Okay. That didn't destroy this one. Okay, it doesn't get destroyed as fast, it seems. Okay, we're getting there. Okay, nice. Oh, they are trapped. Okay, but then I can use that one. Nice. Ah, cool. Go, and now we should be able to get it. Cool. We'll have a lot of words to get here. Okay, well, this is quite interesting. I kind of like the story game idea. This is quite a relaxing game to sit and play. And then there's a little bit of a story, which actually makes me giggle a little bit at times. So, and that was just to show you guys a little bit about what this is about. If it's, if you like to play little games like this, either hidden object games or puzzle games or something, this might be something for you. I actually like playing something like this at times. Okay, right now because I'm talking, I'm not really focusing on what I'm supposed to do here. It might help to take this one and this one so we can get to the blue ones, and then we can take the green ones, and then we can get to you. And, alright, there's not three yet, but there will be now. There we go. Awesome. Okay, well, that was just a little look at this game, so let me know what you think, guys. As always, do take care, and happy gaming!